So I wanted to check if my glass art that I'm making is actually good quality and if my annealing program is working correctly. I got a new kiln and I had to set it up. The built-in programs were really not appropriate for annealing borosilicate, according to my instructor. So I set up my own program and I wanted to see if it was annealing my stuff properly. And I was watching a video on Glass Alchemy's website, and they were talking about using a polarimeter to measure the stresses in glass. And I said, well, that's easy. I can make a polarimeter with stuff that I got lying around the house. And so can you. So I'm going to show you how to do that. All you basically need is a laptop or computer LCD screen. This screen is an LCD screen from LG. It's a 4K LCD type screen. So it has a polarizing filter over the top. That's what makes it work. Now, if you also get a polarizing filter from a camera or some polarizing sunglasses or something like that, then you can put that in front of the laptop screen and you can block the light, right? So it blocks a selective amount of light, which tells me, yes, the light coming from the laptop screen is polarized. Now, it's not totally polarized enough that I can block all of it with my filter, but I can block most of it. And that's going to allow me to see if the glass is rotating light differently in different areas. And that is what shows you the stress lines. So now I want to just prove that this experiment works with a couple of controls. So what I've got here is a piece of soft glass. And I put it in front of the filter here. So this is a piece of soft glass. This is COE 104 glass, and it's been worked on the end. And so I should see a ton of stresses right in the end. And then as you go down the rod, you get to the area that hasn't been worked, that was probably annealed by the company. And I should see a lot less stress up here, right? So, I've got a known control. I've got a known stressed piece of glass. I'm expecting it to look stressed. And sure enough, when I put it in front of the filter, it does, in fact, look very stressed right there. You can see all those lines in it. But then as you move up the rod, you can see it's not so stressed. Now, if I can bend it, while I hold all this stuff, you can also see that stressing the glass lets you see the stressed line. So as I push on that piece, you can kind of see it change. Now this is a small soft glass rod and I can't really bend it that much, but you can see when I push on it, it changes the view just a little bit. You can see that line appearing, and then when I let go, it disappears. Okay, so I can see a little bit of stress in that piece of soft glass. Now, I also have a nice borosilicate rod. This is a little bit bigger rod, but it's longer, and I can stress it a lot more. So when I put the filter in front of that, you can see not a lot of stress in it right now. But if I put the end on the table, get it up in front of the filter here, and then I push on the glass. See that line? I'm pushing on it now. So now I'm going to release. You can see that line go away. So that tells me that yes, my experiment actually works, and it does show me the stresses in the glass. So then I wanted to check, what do commercially made pieces look like compared to my own pieces? So I went down to the local head shop and they sell borosilicate stuff down there. And I went and I asked them, what's the cheapest piece of boro that I can buy? And they had these like dabbing tools, which are essentially just a glass rod that somebody pulled the end off of. Probably takes 5 minutes to make these, literally. So this is what the commercial
piece looks like under the filter. You can see in that portion where they work the glass, there's a ton of stress. You can see the stress lines in the glass very clearly. Right? So that's pretty cool. And then on the other end, you can see a lot of stress where they work the glass. I think this piece probably, it looks like it wasn't annealed at all. Like they probably just made this and set it down on the table and called it good. Now it's thin, so it's probably not gonna break, but it is full of stress, and you can see that in the experiment here. You can see those stress lines. And again, if you stress it, you can see the lines change. So I wanted to compare that with a piece that I made. So I made a piece that was similar, which is this. And I guess these are like little, these are used to smoke oil or whatever that people do. But I made this one, which is a similar piece. And I wanted to see if like this area and the marble itself was stressed after annealing. So turns out that the stuff that I'm doing is actually a lot better than the commercial pieces. And you can actually not really see any stress lines in my piece at all. This is actually very good. Even on the part where I worked it a lot, there's really no stress lines in there at all. Which, that looks great. I'm pretty happy with that. That tells me my annealing program is working right. This one's similar. On that end where I worked it, I would expect to see some stress lines if there were any. And I just don't see anything. And even this end where I created all that, there's really no stress lines. I mean, look at that. That is clear and nice. And that's what your annealing program does in your kiln. It takes that stress out of the glass. Now, I think what I might do with this, I mean, I'm not going to use this, so I don't even really care, but what I might do with this is put it back in my kiln, warm it up slowly to annealing temperature, and then letting it ramp down and see if that stress goes away. It should. But that's what stress looks like under a polarimeter. And really, this is what you should see with your stuff. So there we go. How to measure the stress in your glass.